good crowd. This is what we're looking for. Had a young lady ask me a while ago about, said this is the first thing we're talking about. We did have one back in the early spring, and I'll be honest with you, we did not have a good turnout. And what this is about, what we're going to do this evening, we're going to talk about the park, Holston Creek. We've got the land over here, and this is going to be built for you guys, our public. And we want your input to see what your desires are, what your wishes are, what you want to see built in your community. And first of all, and I apologize for my manners. I think most of you know me. I'm Dale Colbert. I'm the county councilman for this area. And I personally want to welcome each and every one of you here this evening. Thank you so much for coming out. I thank you for your civic pride and loving our community that we live in to come out here and share your desires. And we're here to listen to you this evening. I've got some people here this evening. I know I'm going to miss somebody's name. I've got a few people that I want to recognize. First of all, I feel honored and happy. I've got one of my fellow council members here. I've got Councilman Roger Nutt. Roger's actually going to be filming this proceedings this evening. And Roger's got his, I mean, he's a little fancier than me. Roger's got his own webpage, Facebook, and all that stuff. So, Roger, if they want to see themselves on camera this evening, where are they going to?
Well, I'll post it on my Facebook page, Roger Nutt. You can search that. And it'll take you to the YouTube page where this will be posted probably tomorrow.
Okay, good deal, good deal. If you want him to repeat that, you can talk to him before the end of the meeting. I've got one of my senior mayors here. I've got Mayor Copeland. As usual, it's always good to have you with us, sir, and to see you. I've got my Mayor Venom. I've got Mayor Campbell up here, Bo. Good to have you with us this evening. I've got a couple of my city council members. I've got Councilman Newman with me. I've got Lee Beeves, our councilman from Council Bowl. I've got Dr. Ron Garner from District 1 Schools. I've got Dr. Jimmy Littlefield, former superintendent of District 1, retired and still working though, aren't you, Jimmy? Yeah, I've got Bruce Johnson with us this evening at Rocky Bull. He's the chairman of the local Chamber of Commerce, the Foothills Chamber. Good to have you with us. I just tickled with death. I got Marsha Murr, she's with our Parks and Rec. I've got Mr. Jim Campbell, and he's hard with us. He's a great big guy back here tonight. You won't miss him. I've got one of my very, very good associates. I've got Mr. Jim Hipp, our deputy administrator for Kirk County, is with us this evening. And if I missed anybody, I apologize. Just again, thank you for being here. And I especially want to thank District 1 School for allowing us to use these facilities this evening. We do appreciate that dearly. Thank you so much. What we're going to do this evening, on behalf of County Council, we want to come here and we're going to talk about the Hoston Creek Park. We've got 153 acres over here on Utah Road. We've had this land for quite a while now. Wrong was not built in a day. And, we've been anxious. We've been doing some great things in other parts of the county, and now it's coming around to our turn to start doing some stuff up here. And I'm excited about it, and I know you will be too. And as I said, we want to hear what you guys would like to be built here in our community. Spartanburg County Park Department is in the beginning phase of the park, and we're looking for receiving input from the community. Spartanburg County Park Department has hired consultants along and my friends do a master plan. These are our nice people here, and I'm going to let them introduce themselves as they speak this evening. And just thank you so much again for coming out. And at this time, I'd like to welcome Mr. Vincent McDermott. And he's going to start off with us.
Well, thank you very much. And my colleague, Paul Mills. We happen to be engineers and landscape architects up in Greenville. We've been fortunate to work for the county on a number of projects in the last few years. And I'm delighted to see so many people. How many people, just to give you an idea, how many people were here on April 19th when we had our first meeting? These folks here. Wow. What that tells me is that we need to backtrack. I'm going to give a brief presentation similar to where we started the last time. So if you don't know the site, you'll get a feel for it, I hope. And then we're going to take you through some site analysis. We're going to review the comments from the first meeting. And I'm curious to me as to how many of those comments represent your sentiments. You should know that we're not so far into this design or this master planning process that we can't change. So you'll see some ideas that we put together based on that first meeting. And so we're going to test those assumptions, and if they're different, then we can go back. And so we are not so deep into this that we can't change. We would certainly want this process to represent what you would like to see at Holston Creek, on Holston Creek Drive. So can we do those lines? So calling it meeting number two, which it is, and I think at that time when we met, we said we'll be back here at the end of September, and we are. But with the concern that the county council has had, that the folks that were here the last time weren't widely representative of the entire population, we thought that we would just slow the process down a little bit and prefer to get it right. So Paul's going to be my assistant here tonight, even though he knows a lot more about stuff than I do. All right, so this is the property and its surroundings. This aerial photograph was downloaded from public sources. And the property that here's, this is the entire property right through here. You cut bridge right through here. You can see that there is a pond on the property that was used for irrigation when the property was an orchard. There's another new pond right here that was constructed in part as a result of, we don't see the houses, but this is a new subdivision. And coming right through here is a power transmission line. So this would be New Cut Road. And so that gives you an idea of what the overall boundaries of the property are like. Oh, I'm sorry, there's a third pond here, which is really an irrigation pond. So water was pumped from the larger property, from the larger pond, and then into here for irrigating the farmland. You can also see that this does not show the orchard. It shows what was the orchard. So up in this part of the property what I would call sparsely vegetated, no trees. It is used as a hunting area in agreement with the state of North Carolina. And obviously that would go away once the property is developed. Right in here is the entrance. So as you're traveling on UCAP Road, you'll see the sign that says future site of the county park. And there's a little pull off, and the hunters use that area and then walk up into the property. This area in here, you can see a slightly different color. And that's a natural color. And it shows more wetland area and the like. But right in through here, this part of the westerly part of the property has greater amounts of vegetation. So Paul, why don't we walk through it a little bit more, and I'll give you the 20-minute tour, which I'll condense into about 5 minutes. Holston Creek, look up pretty quickly. It's the Dove Field, and you can see the New Cut Road, the frontage of the road. I'd like to point out that on the opposite side of the road is this fairly high embankment. You've got a drainage ditch and then it goes up. And the significance of that is that the road is adequate for the current traffic, but we would expect that as one would develop a site like this, there may be some roadside improvements that would be required. You can look in the opposite direction of New Cut Road to get a feel for, it's a beautiful country road as far as I'm concerned. It's a two-lane, very safe road, adequate sight distance, so you can turn sight distance being that when someone turns into a property or from the property, you can see in both directions fairly well. This area here, the time this photograph was taken in the spring, that's the construction fence because Duke Power has a transmission facility under construction at that time right behind those trees. And there's actually an easement across that corner of the property allowing internal to the site. And this was taken in very early, late winter, early spring. And you can see how sparsely vegetated the site is. The, well, it was a gorgeous day, I remember, enough for us, Paul and I, to spend an afternoon out tromping around. And you can see, slow down just a second, you can see the top in here, the vegetation is grasses, sparse vegetation. You do see some isolated pine trees and then some deciduous trees. Next slide, please. And then up on the top of the hill, it basically is without vegetation, except some scrub growth that's coming out of the past season. Next, keep going. Just want to slow you down there. So we have some isolated evergreen trees, some remnants of old saplings, and up at the top of the hill you see some vegetation. And this is one of the ponds. This is the first pond that would be up in the westerly, northwesterly corner of the property. And you can, what I point out is the difference in elevation between the water surface and the top of the embankment. And so this is groundwater fed. You can see some water feeding into here. And I haven't seen it very recently, but it rises and falls with whatever the groundwater happens to be. This is the pond into which irrigation from the lower pond was pumped. You can see the remnants, some of the remnants of the old brush in the site. And we're going to look at that again because it's a good reference point. Keep going. You can keep going. Now, when we're up in the top of the site, you can look over into what I consider to be the spectacular part of the site. The higher you get up, the greater view that one would have of the mountain range off to the west. And it is just, to me, this area of the county is spectacular. Some more views. You can begin to see some of the fruiting trees, the flowering trees, the fruit trees coming into bud. Looking farther off, go back one, off more to the north, to the properties adjacent to us on the far side of Holston Creek Park. Okay. So now you're looking in a different, slightly different direction, down over the hill and into the area that is heavily vegetated. You can travel around this site pretty well in the four-wheel drive. There are some old farm roads, farm trails that are still there that are, for the most part, safe. And Paul's forerunner didn't get stuck too badly or in the early spring. But so it's pretty easy to get around for people to walk on as the site is today. Now, what has changed significantly since over the years, that's the new subdivision off to the far side of the property. Barely see right in here, barely see the transmission lines. Just we were able to take a photograph of that one. The significance of these homes are that we have to respect the folks who purchased these properties. And they hopefully knew that this was a county property eventually to be developed as a park. But one of the things that I think we would take cognizance of is the need to maintain their privacy and introduce, where we can, some sort of buffering system so that any impacts that would be inappropriate will be mitigated. You already have some of that occurring because it isn't as bare as in that first slide, but as one goes down the hill toward the south, you begin to have a little thicker vegetation. And over time, left to its own devices, that vegetation would become pretty thick. Beautiful when